Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. So this is the first episode of 2021. So welcome to a new year of 7-Minute AE Tutorials. One of my resolutions is to create more 7-Minute tutorials that are easy to follow, not too fast, and include topics that you can use on a regular basis. Now I made a 2020 year in review video, so if you haven't checked that out yet, please do so at your earliest convenience. The basic messaging was thanking you for being a part of my channel and letting you know of the changes that will be coming to this channel in 2021. This tutorial is the first of a 3-part series on text animators. In this episode, we'll be creating a custom text animation using scale text animators. Now, if you're not familiar with text animators or you don't have a solid grasp on them, then this is the episode for you. Even if you are familiar with them, I highly encourage you to stick around because you may just learn something new. I always include shortcuts and tricks that you can incorporate into other animations. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at AE Juice. Check out their link in the description below to get amazing savings, as well as After Effects assets that are 100% free. And don't forget to tell them that Jeff Knight sent you. So before we get into today's tutorial, let's check out AE Juice. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. There are also plugins to make your workflow much quicker, including Quick Folders, which allows you to quickly navigate to your most often accessed folders. My Pack allows you to add comps for easy access on future projects. My Media allows you to quickly preview sounds, images, videos, and Photoshop and Illustrator files right on your computer so you know what your assets look and sound like before you drop them into your projects. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. While After Effects has a font previewer, this AE Juice feature allows you to see how your actual text will look based on the font that you're previewing. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. There are too many products to mention in this promo, so let's take a quick look at some of the other very cool things you can take advantage of with AE Juice. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles, including their Motion Design Bundle, Animation Presets Bundle, DaVinci Resolve Bundle, bundles for Final Cut Pro, Premiere, Sony Vegas, Avid, and so much more. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All Bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. Please like this video so I can make the YouTube algorithm happy. Share this video and our channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the impressive deals and all the really cool free stuff you can get from AE Juice, the presets we'll be creating, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you may find difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Just want to show you how you can do some pretty cool things with a couple of text animators, and you can save these as presets so that way you can bring them in future projects. Okay, so let's open up this line of text here. We're going to do a scale animation. The way all of these work is you're going to be pulling in some text animators from this animate arrow right here. So click on that and let's choose scale. I like to rename my animators. So I'm going to name this one scale middle, and then I'm going to duplicate that and call this one scale start. Now, one of the things to keep in mind about text animators is that whatever your layer position, scale and rotation or opacity may be, that's going to be where the animation is going to stop. Just real quick, I'm going to pull up my position, scale, rotation, and opacity. Whatever I do to the text animators in these examples, the final resting place for my position, scale, rotation, and opacity will be what I've set here. So for example, if I want to make this dead center, I'm going to change the Y position to 540. So no matter what I would do to my position, it would end up at 96540. Same thing for scale. Since we're going to be doing some scale animations, if I made this 50%, this will be the final scale value. So let's bring that back to 100. So then this will make more sense as we go through these examples. So let's open back up our text tab and we have our start and middle text animators. The way you need to look at these text animators is we want to choose the scale here and the scale here for how we want this to animate in. Okay, so since I want this scale to animate only on the Y value, I'm going to change this to 0. And see, if we just kind of move through here, this is basically the movement that I want. So when I say I want it to animate on the Y value only, we're not scaling up the characters in a uniform way, but only using the Y value. Let's change that to 0. Open up our range selector. Now, this is where the animation is going to be taking place. And you'll be using this offset value here to animate your text animators. Before we get into that, let's open up advanced. And something to take note of is this shape here. The ones we'll be looking at today are square, ramp up, and ramp down. And depending on which one of these you have selected, it's going to dictate what your offset values are going to be. Let's leave it at square for right now. And the offset values for square are going to be 0 to 100. So we can put a keyframe there for offset at 0%. And I'm just going to shift page down to go forward 10 frames and move up to 100. It's kind of quick, so let's move this keyframe out a little bit. The reason why it's animating in one character at a time is because we have our based on set to characters. You can change this to characters excluding spaces. We're not going to really touch on that because it's basically the same thing as characters. It just doesn't take into account the spaces between words, like between Jeff and Knight or 7 and Minute, but they're basically the same thing. And you can also choose words, so they will come in one word at a time. Or you can choose lines where they come in one line at a time. So I'm going to choose characters for now, and I'm going to do something a little bit interesting with this. So see, right now they're coming in from first character to last character. Well, you can choose this randomize order. It defaults to off, so let's change that to on. So now these will come up in a random order. For me, they come in a little bit too quick. So what I want to do is I'm going to change this square setting to ramp up. So now since I changed it to ramp up, my offset values are going to change. So see, one more time, change this back to square. Our percentages are from 0 to 100. With ramp up, they're from negative 100 to 100. And this value is going to be the opposite for ramp down, and I'll show you in just a second. But for right now, if we watch this play back, we can kind of see how they come in a little bit slower. Okay, and I'm just going to move this second keyframe in so that way it comes in a little bit quicker. This is going to be the beginning of our animation. Let's go to our scale middle. Go back and notice that our scale is set to 100.0. This scale middle, I want to set to 100.135, so that way it kind of goes up like that. And remember, the final resting place is going to be the scale that we originally set for our layer. And that's only true if these values, like for scale, are set at 100.100. Just highlight these two text animators and let's hide these. And as you can see, without the text animators, my scale is exactly the same. Well, now if I change this value here for scale middle to 135, we see how it animates higher. Well, now if we take that off, we can see that it goes back to our original scale. So the main thing to remember is that your text animators are going to interact with your layer settings. So let's go ahead and finish up this animation. So we're going to set this to 135, and then I'm going to put a keyframe here for 0. Go for maybe 10 frames and crank it up to 100. And then we watch that playback. We can see how it animates up and animates back down. Not too crazy about that animation, but there's some things that we can do. So let's open back up our advanced tab here. Our shape is set to square. So let's open up our other range selector. And remember, we changed this to ramp up. Let's change this shape also to ramp up. Make our first keyframe negative 100. And if we watch that playback, you get something a little bit more interesting. Now, there's some cool things you can do with this. See, like if we offset these a little bit more, so hit U to show our keyframes, we get something that looks a little bit more like an animation that we might want to use. But there's some other cool things that you can do with this. Okay. And this is best seen when these keyframes are lined up more like this, where the animation down begins where the animation up stops. So remember, we have our animation based on characters. Well, we can change the second one, for example, to words. So you can see how the text animates up one character at a time, but then the animates back down one word at a time. So you can kind of mix these up a little bit to kind of get a different kind of feel. And again, we can offset these just depending on what you're going for. And notice too, we have our randomization order off. So let's turn that on. So that way we get more randomization. So this is just mainly to show you some of the options that you have. I'm going to move this over. And then I'm going to change this from words back to characters. So now you can save these text animations as presets, which is really helpful. Let's just close up all these outer containers, highlight text and transform. We watch that playback. That's our animation that we want. Let's go up to animation, save animation preset. And you want to make sure that you're in your documents, Adobe, the version you're using. User presets, and then I'm going to make a new folder, and you can do this too. And I'm going to call this 7 minute text animators. And then let's open that up. And then I'm going to name this something that I'll remember. So scale bounce and let that preset save. Okay. And now let's double check to make sure that this worked. Go over to effects and presets, and we want to look up scale underscore bounce. And there it is. And notice it's under user presets. And then the folder I created for 7 minute text animators. I'm just going to get rid of this entire layer. Now watch, if I just double click on this with nothing in my timeline, it will bring back in the text that we originally typed. So that's kind of cool too. To bring them in, you don't have to even actually apply them to a text layer. Now you may want to go ahead and have your text set so that way you know what you're going to be animating and you sort all of that out before you start to animate. But you can always just bring this in by double clicking in your user presets and it will bring in the text that was used to save the original text animation preset. So now I never have to create this again. If I want to bring this into a new project, all I got to do is search for scale bounce or look in the folder for 7 minute text animators. And I have this animation. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. Click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please share this video and our channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please leave me a message in the comments and tell me what you learned from this episode. Come back next week for part 2 of this 3-part series to learn more about text animators. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, to the impressive deals and all the really cool free stuff from AE Juice, the presets we created, and the project files for this tutorial are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.